Thanks, Mary. This morning in the kitchen, we are cooking with the Providence War Convention and Visitor Bureau. And this morning is Benjamin Sukle from the Dorrance. Thanks for being with us today.
Thank you very much for having me.
How are you?
I'm great.
What are we making this morning?
So we're taking some really, really good local ingredients, scup and some root vegetables, and we're going to bake them in a salt dough.
Okay. You know, when I heard the fish we were cooking this morning, I've never actually heard of that fish, and I've been here all my life.
It's well known in the waters. They call it silver bass. It can be known as porgy as well. It's very, very plentiful. It's very sustainable. Really, really great fish. Similar to snapper, but local.
Okay, and you know, one of the interesting facts you were telling us, we have the cards on here, and you can actually tell what ship they've come
exactly,
from.
Exactly, right? Yeah. Wild Rhode works with Trace and Trust, and they every fish that's caught, it can be traced back to when it was caught, who caught it, and where.
Nice. What else do we have here?
So here are the root vegetables we're going to be cooking. It's kohlrabi, which is a kind of a German turnip. There's also hikari turnips, very, very nice light beets. And then here are the ingredients for the miso dough, salt and miso, which is miso, salt, local ground rye flour, and just regular flour. We're going to do a pumpkin seed brown butter.
Okay.
And then a watercress puree.
Now, this is pretty easy for anybody to do. I don't want people, you know, freaking out and going, oh my God, I'm never going to be able to do this.
It's very, very easy. Plus, it's cool to have if you're having a dinner party. It's a great presentation to have a whole fish come out and it's baked in a crust and everything, and it's also what we use in the restaurant to kind of build flavors off of ingredients.
And even the salt here, we have the salt that we're going to put in, and not so much for flavor, right?
Yeah, it's used as a cooking medium. Obviously, you need salt to have stuff taste well, but then it's also used to really seal in moisture when you're baking the ingredients.
Okay, perfect. All right, we're going to get our ingredients all set here, and we will go back to you.
Thanks, Mary. We are cooking along with Ben Sukle from the Dorrance, and not only are we cooking today, but we're getting a little lesson in cooking as well. Is that right?
Yeah, absolutely. We're using a technique that we use at the restaurant to almost like take vegetables or fish or something into this, instead of just simply grilling it, which is fine, we just kind of take it a step further. In this case, we're using a salt dough.
A salt dough.
That's right. Okay. Basically Play-Doh.
Explain, please.
So salt dough is basically, it's a Play-Doh. And then in this case, we use miso as well because it's a really good earthiness and just really adds to seafood and vegetables, root vegetables specifically. And you mix a dough. It's flour, salt, miso, and just water, and that's about it.
Wow, and touch upon the fact that, you know, we're using salt as more than just flavoring. We're actually cooking with it.
Yeah, exactly. We're using it as a cooking medium. It's really, really wonderful. It's sealing in moisture. It cooks fish evenly. It cooks vegetables evenly. Mm-hmm. It really keeps a nice moist environment and steams almost as well.
Now, why is this beneficial to use something as salt, to use it as a cooking medium rather than just for flavoring?
Well, just what I said, it's just very, very moist. It seals in moisture. It also gives you a chance to add a different flavor, which is why we're using the miso as well.
Perfect. So just a different option for you
exactly.
when you're cooking at home.
Exactly. Just another way to make something delicious.
Awesome. Something delicious. Can't wait to make it. It's going to be coming up a little later in the show. For now, back to you. Back in the Roadshow Kitchen this morning, we're getting some tips from the pros from GoProvidence.com, and we're cooking along with Chef Ben Sukle from the Dorrance. And Ben, we talked about before this salt dough that we're making, so how do we make this?
It's really, really easy. It's five ingredients. So what you really want to do is just add all the first four ingredients, the dry and the miso.
Okay.
Then go right in.
And how much of each ingredient are we using?
So you're adding 2 cups of the local ground rye flour, 2 cups of flour, 2.5 cups of salt, and 1 cup of miso.
And where are we able to get this? I mean, is this local market stuff that we can pick up?
The miso you can get at any Asian market. And the local flour, the rye flour, is available at Shartner Farm, which is in Exeter.
Oh, okay. Excellent. Love Shartner Farm.
I love Shartner Farm.
So, so we'll get that mixing. You can do that on medium speed if you want to.
Medium speed.
There we go.
Okay, and then we just add some
slowly
water,
add
right?
water. Yep, slowly add water till it forms a dough. It's pretty simple.
Okay.
And how long is this going to mix for?
Once it forms together, you're pretty much done.
We're good to go.
Yeah,
okay.
You can keep going. Yeah, see right there, you can stop.
All right.
If we want
so that blends for a little while, and it's going to become a dough.
Yep, exactly. And so when it becomes a dough, you're going to want to let it rest for a little, like any kind of dough.
Okay. So that it can rise up a little bit.
Exactly.
Right?
Okay. Well, so it can rise and relax and absorb some of the flavors as well. And also some of the, because the rye flour you can see in the actual dough are the really dark spots.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I like that.
So you want that flavor to get into everything. Mm-hmm. So what you'll do is let it rest for a little while. You roll it out really, really about 1/4 inch thick. Very, very easy. And then what we'll do is with the local fish, is that we put
yeah.
it
between. Oh, yeah.
Exactly, yeah. So it's going to be on a bed of herbs on each side. That's to kind of protect it and also really for flavor.
It almost becomes like a little oven for it.
Exactly, yeah. exactly. That's really the point.
Right,
it's really
right.
even cooking, really
okay.
moist. So you'll take that and you put it into a 400 degree oven.
For how long?
About 20 minutes. And what's not easy, we can put it in this
okay.
bottom guy.
Bottom.
Okay. About 20 minutes, and what's nice is that you can take a thermometer and put it right through the dough. It's okay. Don't eat the dough, though.
Okay.
It's
oh.
really gross if you
oh.
eat the dough.
Oh, okay. Do not eat the dough.
I thought we were eating the dough.
No.
I'm glad you're here, Ben.
Yeah, good thing he said that. We would have just went right in with the
I was looking at the dough going, that doesn't look so bad.
All right, so this is our finished one.
Yep, and then also what we have here are the vegetables, the root vegetables that are pretty much cooked the exact same way, just a little bit longer.
Okay.
So what we can do is that the vegetables can open up
that.
And you
I'll
can see.
Off.
Wow.
That's awesome.
So those as well. So what we have is the kohlrabi, the turnips, and the beets.
Yum.
And then here, we can kind of just crack.
Oh, wow.
Look at that.
Oh, that comes right off.
Look out for that. The steam comes out quick.
Woo!
Right? Comes right out.
And what kind of herbs do you use to season this?
It's really whatever you like. What okay. we have here is parsley, oregano, and thyme.
Yum.
And sealing it all together must really absorb those
exactly.
you know, flavors
and really
everything
smell
else
it.
In it.
It okay. Honestly, it smells very bready, almost like really nice and yeasty on there
yeah.
as well.
Yeah, oh gosh, it's so good. So good.
Okay, so next.
Yeah.
So next
talk about
step.
This brown butter.
So the brown butter, it's very, very simple. It's this brown butter. I like to use a really hot pan, cold butter.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Milk solids don't evaporate as quick, so you get more of the brown butter solids in there. And then just tossed in with some pumpkin seeds, salt, and pepper. And then also we're just going to finish with just a little bit of fresh lemon in there.
Oh, love that.
And then we
juice.
Can also use that lemon for the fish as well.
Lemon and fish just go
yeah.
so well together.
Yeah, it brightens it up a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
So then what we can do...
Put this over here.
Yeah, there we go. Put this guy right here.
Okay.
And we can
put that back.
And now, oh, now we're plating.
Oh, okay, we're going to put the plate.
Presentation
right, here we go.
Is everything.
There's our plate. So what we can do is we can start with taking some of the vegetables.
Okay.
And just a couple of each.
Just scoop them on in
you
there.
You want to remind everybody what these veggies are again?
So this is kohlrabi, what I'm putting on the plate right now.
Okay.
And that's just, it's a turnip that has very, very cabbagey flavors, broccoli flavors. Mm-hmm. It's really, really good, underutilized.
Sounds delicious.
Beets.
I love beets.
And then some regular turnips
regular
as well.
Regular turnip.
Okay.
And how are you going to scoop the fish out of here?
It's very, very easy. Just a fish spatula.
Spatula.
Or is it
going to
come apart
simple.
Really easy?
It should come off right...
Nothing fancy. I'm thinking
over.
Some crazy tool is going to be used.
Just a spatula. Oh, there we go. Man,
wow.
Nice, hot.
Oh, and it's so...
It.
You can tell that moisture. It's so... flaky, it's just coming apart already.
And this is one of the dishes we can get at the Dorrance, correct?
Yes, absolutely. I mean, some of the vegetables will cook and they'll be on the regular dishes as well.
Now, how does it work with the skin of this fish? Is that okay to eat, too?
Absolutely. So we
okay.
also have to put the brown butter on there.
Oh, right. what am I doing? I'm just
butter.
So excited to try it.
So some brown butter.
Mm-hmm.
And then also what we have here is a watercress puree. Watercress we can get locally as well. And
okay.
it's just basically pureed with olive oil and Dijon mustard. So it adds really, really nice brightness and color. And really good flavor as well.
Delicious.
Okay.
All right, I'm
going to
try a bite
okay,
of this.
Okay, I was going to give a try of that. And for
oh,
all of
yeah.
these recipes, you can head over to our website, WPRI.com.